Hi, I'm Kahchun, and you're watching Bandwagon TV. Really lucky to have met all these wonderful teachers all my life. The first person that opened my door to music was not a music teacher, he was a maths teacher. My primary one form teacher was also teaching maths, and he just introduced us to all the class students to sign consent forms, to get parents to sign our consent forms to join the band. Without really knowing what we were doing, I got into the band and I was there for 6 years. I enjoyed myself very much. I had a great band instructor, Mrs. Chua. And then I was in the River Valley Band. In River Valley High School, I had, again, a great band instructor, Ms. Chan. And then I was in the JC Band, another great teacher, Mr. Ora. So I was meeting all these really helpful, very supportive people across the span of my musical journey. And everyone has been, I think, had a real sense of support and a real sense of being there for all of us, not just me, but everyone who's in the club, in the band. Metal music, a mix of stuff.
Well, can you talk about the metal that you like?
So I really like this band, Dream Theater. A lot of the musicians graduated from Juilliard, so classical music trained. But their music is fantastic. I was listening to a lot. A friend from Army introduced to me this band. We were in the military band, SAF band, and so we would take all these trips all around Singapore to go to different camps because our work was to play in parade for some contingent to march to or for something. And so during all these long bus rides, my friend would be listening to something and then I would be like intercepting a earphone, and I found that Dream Theater was a band that I just liked very much. Very instrumental, great singing, and great music. So Beethoven was a disruptor. He was a game changer. So before him, you had great names like Haydn, Mozart, Salieri, and fantastic composers who set the path for music. But Beethoven did that and more. He was going deaf in his life, and he overcame this disorder, and he wrote 9 incredible symphonies, the number six, which we're going to be performing on the 5th of October. But he wrote also, for example, the ninth symphony, which is the EU anthem, which is also Ode to Joy, and a message to connect humanity together, the brotherhood of mankind. So someone like Beethoven, it's once in a lifetime you have an artist like him. Beethoven was one of the first, if not the first, composer who would say, no, I do what I want. I write because I'm free to write. And the idea of romanticism itself, that the artist is a free person. And next year, it's going to be his 250th birthday. So I think next year we're going to have something big as well. So the quintessential image that we have of Beethoven is this portrait, and his hair's really meshed up and he's really angry. And in this sense, it's very similar to his music, because you have the music going very beautiful, and then suddenly it has this Fifth Symphony, this knocking at the fifth, ba-ba-ba-ba, ba-ba-ba-ba. It's not been done before by any composer. And he comes in and he says, no, I have to make this statement and this has to be it. And he's introduced the idea of self, a real honest self into music itself. And composers from then on have been so shaken by him. For example, Johannes Brahms, a great composer in his own right, delayed the completion of his first symphony until when he was in his 40s, because he was just so overwhelmed by the shadow of Beethoven. Composers around those times in the 1840s, were quite overwhelmed, I would imagine, in my own opinion, by the triumph of Beethoven, that after he passed away for 10 years, for 20 years, people would still be worried about or in self-doubt if their own symphony is really a continuation of what Beethoven has done, or it would take a different pathway.
We picked Kahchun for a very simple reason. When my wife came here and I came here to Singapore about 2 years ago, the first thing we did was go to the Esplanade and listen to a concert where he was conducting the SSO and they were playing Beethoven's Fifth Symphony. The energy that he generated, the power that he had in directing the orchestra was something that I have never seen before. We met in the intermission, we talked a little bit to each other, and I found out that he actually spent some time in Germany. And not only spent some time, but he studied there and built part of his career in Germany. And we agreed on a breakfast that Sunday morning after we met that he would be available to give an open-air concert in the Botanic Garden, which we would dedicate to Beethoven, one of his favorite composers and musicians, as much as Beethoven is obviously, as a German composer, one of our favorites. And this is how our love affair, if you allow me to say that, started. Germany was one of the first to recognize Singapore some 54 years ago in its independence, and we have been close friends with Singapore all the time. The relationship is perfect. We have around about 8,500 Germans living here, dwelling here with their families and feeling extremely comfortable. The number of companies is growing, and we see that the bridges that we have been trying to build in the past are becoming stronger and stronger.
More and more Singaporeans are studying in Germany. There's a growing Singaporean population, and I've been very lucky because there is an incredibly supportive Singaporean embassy in Berlin, where I studied at. So they would host National Day parties, Chinese New Year parties, and so Singaporeans from all around Germany would come. And I have been there twice, and I remembered that the second year was bigger, much bigger than the first year. So I imagine this is a very clear sign that it's growing. And the German community in Singapore, I mean, you have all these wonderful companies here, but on a person-to-person level, I'm meeting Germans who are in Nuremberg, for example, but after a concert and they come to me and they say, you know, we were working in Singapore for 3 years. We were just in Singapore last week for this event, or for F1, or for New Year. We wanted to spend it somewhere in Asia, and we found Singapore. And so there is a lot of mention both ways, Singapore and Germany. And for me, I really take pride when I'm really proud and I'm really happy. Just because I go to different places in Germany and beyond to perform, and after a concert, people would come up to me and say, are you Singaporean? Because we were there and we liked this and we liked that, and food, it's always high on the agenda of anyone. It makes me a little bit happy that I know in my little private work as a conductor, sharing my music or sharing the music of Germans, of Europeans around the world, that I can wave a little flag of Singapore around.